Tony. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is David Gere. I'm Dean here, and it is my great pleasure and honor to begin this event. We're going to have a real celebration for you today. You can read about his storied career, Tony's storied career, in your program. But what we all know is he is just a wonderful human being, and the evidence of that is all these people who have come from far and wide to celebrate, listen to some music, and enjoy part of his great legacy as a musician and teacher. So, ladies and gentlemen, Tony Elliott, let's enjoy the afternoon.
Thank you. I've been a pianist for over 70 years. Tonight, I wish I were a cellist. It's so beautiful. Tony, I wanted to be on this program, and I wanted to honor you. You are a great colleague, you're a great friend, you're a great musician. We have worked together, you and I. We've played, the audience may not know this, we have played Beethoven trios, we played Mozart, we played Tchaikovsky trio. You were the conductor in the Dexter Symphony, and you invited me to play, and we played a concerto that I always wanted to play, the last Mozart, 595. And your conducting and your musicality was just absolute joy to work with. From a personal standpoint, it fulfilled a lifelong wish of mine to play that concerto. We've served on committees together. Some of the grayer side of academia, we were on the undergraduate and graduate curriculum committees. There was at one time, I believe, for a brief amount of time, at least we went to a meeting of the library committee. You may not remember that. I do. We've been on the scholarship committee together. We have adjudicated our concerto competitions together. We have done many, many things in the world of academia together. I have worked with you, with a few students. I've talked with you about teaching. We have had wonderful conversations. And in every single way, Tony Elliott has been a mensch. A wonderful, wonderful colleague. So I wanted to be here and share my own particular gratitude for your presence on the faculty. And I want to wish you and Paula continued happiness, nachas, I believe is the Hebrew word, in your retirement, and having a wonderful lifetime, a wonderful experience. Thank you for being you.
Professor Elliott and Paula and the wonderful community of SMTD. It's always wonderful to be back as an alumna. I'm Afra Dworkin. I serve as president and artistic director for the Sphinx organization. I'm also a proud former student of Mr. Elliott's and played in a variety of different chamber ensembles, but I also consider Jerry a wonderful lifelong mentor. So my husband and I are here to just pay a short tribute. My story, there could be so many, but we were told 60 minutes. 60 seconds. There could be so many, but my story and memory is one of an example of how Professor Elliott always taught us and inspired us to do better through diplomacy and grace. I have this wonderful memory of being at the stage of Hill Auditorium, and there's the Sphinx Symphony on stage, and one of the wonderful young virtuosos who were preparing their concerto for the finals concert to be televised on Detroit Public Television. And I remember watching Tony reach out to the violinist, hold his hand and say, "I have a dilemma. I hear this eight differently than you do. I see that the orchestra is hearing it yet differently than we do. I wonder if we can solve the problem." It was his most polite and wonderful, elevated way of saying, "You're out of tune." It stayed with me because it's just such an example of how Tony taught us to think together, to be collaborative, and strive to do better through diplomacy and through a kind way of appealing our better selves. I always appreciate that of so many different qualities. And always pay tribute and remember about how you taught us to do better.
And it really is just an honor to be able to be part of celebrating everything that you have shared with so many people. And there are, of course, innumerable stories, but two quick things that I just wanted to share with everyone. First, the Sphinx Virtuosi on their inaugural tour, young musicians being able to go out around the country and especially go to Carnegie Hall and play on that stage. as we thought about who could we entrust to lead them artistically, but also humanly. And of course, Tony, you did that. And my recollections of that moment on stage at Carnegie Hall, and all of these young people had never been on the stage before, and the tears that they had in their eyes, and the way that you inspired and led them musically and emotionally and spiritually was just truly profound, and it stays with all of them. And I know you have that impact on so many people, and it really is extraordinary. And it makes me remember this amazing quote that Tony gave to this documentary that was being done. And they were just asking what you thought about music and its importance. And Tony shared, and I hope I get this right, but he shared that, you know, in Major League Baseball, if you hit the ball 40% of the time, you will be, you know, in the Hall of Fame. In basketball, if you, you know, sink the three-pointers 60% of the time, you'll be an all-star. But if you go on stage and you play 90% of the notes right in the Beethoven Violin Concerto, people are going to want their money back. And it was amazing because it was this comment on the importance of excellence in our craft. And you've been able to have just an entire lifetime group of young people and professionals who you've been able to touch, not only in terms of the artistic excellence and merit that you bring, but the human aspects of why it is that we do this art that we do and play the music that we do and try to impact people. So thank you so much. You are an inspiration to both of us and an inspiration to so many. Thank you for everything.
A great teacher teaches a lot more than the subject matter. And in this case, Tony taught me a lot more than just playing the cello. I'm going to talk about two things. I'm going to talk about the drive, and I'm going to talk about the gesture. The drive. In 1976, when I was 17, Tony drove me all the way from Minneapolis down to Bloomington, Indiana, which is a 9 or 10 hour drive. During that time, I had a chance to observe him and how he interacted with others, especially when he was pulled over by the police. I got to observe how he dealt with the police officer in a very calm and dignified manner. And then in Bloomington, Indiana, at the home of Janos Starker, I observed him having a conversation with Mr. Starker. I think everyone, most people in this audience know Janos Starker is a very famous cellist of the 20th century. And he's not an easy person to converse with. But Tony, once again, interacted in a calm and professional and dignified manner, which helped me a lot, because a year after that, I was invited to the home of Jacqueline Dupre in London, invited for dinner. And so I went there for dinner, and it was Jacqueline and me alone for 1 or 2 hours. But I knew what to do, because I'd already learned it from Tony. So I acted in a calm, dignified manner. I said I was going to talk about the gesture. This is the gesture that I'm talking about. Those who can't see, it's where I don't know how to describe it, but I pat my hand to emphasize things. That gesture comes from Tony. It's something that I saw him do at some point, and I took it on, and I've done it ever since. Maybe I do it every day, but this right here, this gesture, that's Tony.
Professor Elliott, you've put so much care, positivity, and grace into this world. I hope we're able to reflect even a fraction of that back to you today. The experience I've taken with me since my time here is that I always felt like I meant more than just as the student who showed up every Thursday at 11:30 in the morning for 4 years in a row. I always felt like you went above and beyond for your students to care for them, not just as players, but as people. For many of us, myself included, our time here was our first experience living on our own, And the fact that you were always there to provide a kind word or a caring gesture has meant so much to me throughout the years. I'll never forget how you and your wonderful family every Thanksgiving always make as much room as needed at your table for any students who aren't able to make the trip home. The years spent in school are hopefully years of change and growth, and as all of us know, that's not always easy. But the experience is made so much richer by the benefit of a teacher who advocates for you, who supports you, and pushes you to be the best you can be every single day. Professor Elliott, thank you so much for everything that you've given to all of us who are lucky enough to call ourselves your students. Congratulations. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Abby Allen. I graduated here in 1996, and I had the great privilege of studying with Professor Tony Elliott for my cello degree. I'm currently the orchestra director at Clegg Middle School, right around the corner in the Ann Arbor Public Schools. I just would like to say a few things about how much Mr. Elliott has been my cheerleader over many, many trials and events in my life. While at the University of Michigan in the 1990s, many were discouraging my interests in improvisation and contemporary forms, but not Mr. Elliott. He saw my passion and encouraged me to pursue contemporary forms of cello playing, and I can't tell you how important this was to me as an undergraduate, and I felt so encouraged by him as a young musician. After developing severe tendonitis in my left hand, during that time, Mr. Elliott ushered me gently through this ordeal, teaching me strategies for approaching the cello in a new way. As the circumstances of a soon-to-be graduate, I relied on his understanding and support and eventually came to an important revelation. I realized that I actually loved to teach and could find my way as a musician and a teacher. I am grateful for his steady support during this time and it has had profound impact on me as a person. During my career as a teacher, Mr. Elliott has been an incredible resource and mentor. Those of you who have dedicated your lives to the noble profession of music teacher know well the challenge of balancing teaching with time and practice and performance. Mr. Elliott has continually opened his door to me, offering his time, his expertise, and even opportunities to extend my career as the assistant conductor with the Dexter Community Orchestra. In his humble, unassuming way, Mr. Elliott has given and given again, often without recognition, to young people in the public schools through the Michigan Youth Orchestra and his work with the Sphinx Organization. He has shown many the way towards studying music at the university level, and as a constant advocate for music in the schools and for quality musical experiences for our youth. Mr. Tony Elliott, you deserve the highest accolades for your musicianship, but especially to your dedication to your students and for caring so much, often unseen. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for all that you have given, and congratulations on your retirement.
Bergman. And last September, when Tony announced that he was going to retire, Gail and I had him all over for dinner. And it was a celebration. But I must say it felt a lot like this afternoon. It's a combination of the most joyous sounds and some sad ones, too. And isn't that what it's all about? Both things. So it's possible that I may have known Tony longer than anybody else in this room, even Paula. Because in 1965, Tony and I were high school students as part of the New York All-State Orchestra, which met at the Concord Hotel in Kiamisha Lake, New York. After the opening rehearsal, the conductor announced that the next thing that was going to happen was we were going to go and play the hardest passages of the Flying Dutchman solo. And I was terrified, I think Tony was. Neither of us had seen anything quite that hard in our lives for orchestra. So somehow we survived, and we ended up sitting across from each other in the orchestra. And from that experience, now more than 50 years ago, a lot of threads have developed that have gone forward. Of course, for Tony, he has continued the experience with the All-State Orchestras, only this time from the other side of the podium. And by now, he must have conducted everybody in the country. any state you haven't been to, I'm not sure if that's possible.
Rhode Island.
That was the last one for me, too. So he did a great service and reached, I'm sure, thousands of young musicians that way, many of whom have gone on to have careers in music, and some of them have come here to continue their education, and I would guess that there's some people in this room today who have that connection. For many years, I played in a string quartet called the Concord Quartet. And a quartet of any kind is actually, looks like four people, but in fact, it's an entire village because there are spouses, there are children, there are parents, there are teachers, there are friends, there are managers, there are, unfortunately, there are critics too. But in any case, Tony became part of this village when he married Paul, because Paula's brother, Mark, was my colleague in the quartet. So Tony is really quartet-in-law. Anyway, as a result of that, we ended up playing many, many concerts together. Probably more Schubert quartets than we did with anybody, was with Tony, and also new pieces that were commissioned. We toured all over the place, and I just have to recall one story, which is we were in Edmonton, or was it Calgary?
Calgary, I think.
Calgary. You can always rely on Tony's memory. He never forgets anything. Calgary, and we got off the plane, and it was, you know, a balmy minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit in Calgary, and we rented a very small station wagon with the five of us and instruments and luggage. And we were trying to pack everything into this little car, and which resulted in a certain amount of sardine-like quality. And in order to avoid turning into a big tent icicle, we jumped into the car as fast as we could, slammed the doors, and all the plastic in the car shattered because it was so cold. And we spent the rest of the tour picking pieces of Chrysler beige plastic out of our luggage and our hair. any event, one of the things that I find most wonderful is that I've had the chance, I think, to experience some of Tony's early conducting experiences out at Barrowstone Music Festival in Washington State, where he worked with the summertime version of the Seattle Youth Symphony. Of course, he has also continued to work with youth orchestras here in Houston and in a lot of other places. And our teaching paths crossed quite a number of times, both State and also in Houston and at, in Western Michigan. Sorry, that's, I shouldn't have said that. And also, of course, here. And I've seen his wonderful total commitment to his students, to a passionate, devoted nature of how he speaks to everyone, how he gives everybody their due. His advice, his ethically based moral encouragement for his students and for the rest of us on the faculty have really changed the nature of what goes on here. This is a different school than it was 25 years ago when Tony first came. And I honor him for it and thank the both of you for having been such a strong influence here and everywhere. Thank you.
Thank you. I feel that I have been blessed to work with two of the great things society has to offer, these wonderful young people, and also this wonderful profession that we have of music and being a music teacher. It has been an honor for me, and I can't express enough the good fortune that I feel that I've had to have had this musical life and this opportunity to work as a musician performing, as a conductor, as a teacher working with these young people. I feel incredibly blessed, and I thank all of you who managed to surprise me. I thought I was coming to Nathaniel Pierce's recital. This was great, absolutely great, and I look forward to getting a chance to be with all of you, and I am greatly honored to have had a chance to know so many wonderful, wonderful people, and thank you for coming out today. It means the world to me. Absolutely. Thank you so much.